Okay, so I'm not too sure what you're actually going to be able to see here. We're kind of out here in the morning. Sun's in front of us, so hopefully we'll get in a somewhat decent picture here. So I just finished planting the cranberry bush, and now I want to plant, oh, of course I would forget, wouldn't I? A tiger eyes cut leaf staghorn sumac. So I believe this is about 12 feet tall, I think. Might be wrong, I might have to add that in here when it's mature growth. So what I'm planning on doing is putting it pretty much maybe a little bit to the right of where it is right now, and in that way it will be kind of centered with our trellis over here next to the house, climbing rose eventually growing on that trellis, and hydrangeas, bushes growing up, etc. You can see over here where we did some cleanup on our weeping willow. Can't see it quite as well from this angle as you did from, when you're coming out of the shop. You can see you probably saw in a previous video that somebody had used it as their deer rack. We've gone ahead and taken that down, took down a couple of limbs. We left a couple dead limbs just for, the sake of birds and whatnot. And this one off to the right-hand side, it'll probably come down in a storm one of these days, but it's not going to hurt anything. It's not going to hit the house. The top part of it might one day, but anyhow. And we went ahead and left the little one bys that they had for stairs, I guess. I don't know. Maybe there was a tree house in it at one time, I believe, probably. So anyhow, just did a little basic cleanup there. And then I don't know. I don't know if I'll mulch around that or not. I kind of don't mind. A little bit of trimming here and there is fine. And on something like that, if there's some tall grass around it, I don't know. It just doesn't really bother me that much. Maybe, we start seeing a lot of ticks or something like that, I probably would cut it down. Anyhow. So yeah, so that's the plan, is to kind of plant this one right in here in between. And when you're driving down the road, then there'll be something to kind of see the house but cover the house, kind of a thing. So anyhow, all right, I'm gonna get started on that, and I might lose you here in a minute because my battery's going dead, but I'll get started on it. Okay, so our retractable hose doesn't quite reach this far, so I went and grabbed an extra hose that we had and threw it in the wheelbarrow and drug it over. Started to lay it out so that I could attach our retractable hose, and apparently there was enough water left in that hose that it wet the hole down and allowed me to finish opening up the dirt. So I got it planted. Still don't have mulch, so we'll get mulch eventually and get it mulched for the winter. And what I'm going to do right now is go get a lemonade. So I got a bunch of mulch yesterday and I unloaded it at last night, and I thought this is probably not going to get put down for weeks and weeks and weeks until October. And I come out this morning and right now it is 66 degrees. You probably can't even see the sun back there. It's so hazy out. So it's pretty hazy out, but the temperature is right. So we're going to get started on putting some mulch down. Awesome. Just walking over to where I've got the mulch laying at, and this pumpkin vine, it took a turn and it's still heading for the driveway though. look how pretty the flowers are going to be on that gourd up there, on the gourd plant. I hope it gets around the arbor just a little bit more. That is so pretty.
Thank you.
not quite looking exactly how I wanted it to, but I'm out of mulch. I think I'll wait till, I'll give it a couple weeks, and when I work on the blackberry patch, I'll see if I have any mulch left, or if I need to get a couple more bags. Then I'll go ahead and get a couple more bags.